न्यूमोकोनियोसिस इज अ रिस्ट्रिक्टिव डिसऑर्डर और इसमें बहुत सारे ग्रुप ऑफ डिसऑर्डर्स इंक्लूडेड हैं. सो आज जनरल न्यूमोकोनियोसिस की बात करते हैं. बेसिकली जब ये टर्म इनिशियली क्वाइन हुआ था तो इट यूज टू डिस्क्राइब दोज लंग डिसऑर्डर्स जो कि मिनरल डस्ट से होते थे, बट फिर अब रिसेंट टाइम्स में इसकी डेफिनेशन को फर्दर ब्रॉड किया गया है एंड नाउ इट ऑल्सो इंक्लूड्स द डिजीजेज induced by organic as well as inorganic particles and some of the lung experts also include even chemical fume and vapor induced lung diseases in the section of pneumoconiosis, right? Achha, jo original iski jo definition thi mineral dust pneumoconiosis, usme teen common aapko particles yaad rakhne hai jo inhale agar ho jaye for long period of time they cause pneumoconiosis and they include inhalation of coal, dust obviously, and silica dust and asbestos. Now all those factory or company workers who are working in these companies, they are highly prone to develop pneumoconiosis lung disorders. Okay, asbestos is an exception, as with this mineral the increased risk of cancer extends to the family members of asbestos workers as well. So main aise students se kehta hu ki this is one of the non microbial कंटेजियस डिसऑर्डर. आप ज़रा सोचें इस बात को कि हम बात करते हैं ना कि अगर किसी को निमोनिया है तो कफ से वो निमोनिया स्प्रेड होगा फैमिली मेम्बर्स को, ट्यूबरक्लोसिस है, इवन कोविड था. सो दीज आर ऑल द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच आर स्प्रेडिंग टू द फैमिली मेम्बर्स, बट एस्बेस्टोस इज नॉट एन इन्फेक्शियस ऑर्गेनिज्म बट दिस कैन इवन स्प्रेड टू द फैमिली. ओके, सो वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एक्सेप्शन कि न्यूमोकोनियोसिस में वन ऑफ दैम इज कंटेजियस. ओके, now this table 13.3 it indicates the pathologic conditions associated with each mineral dust and the major industries in which dust exposure may produce the disease. Hum ye teenon alag alag se is pe video hogi hamari. We will in the subsequent videos we will talk about coal dust, pneumoconiosis, silicosis and asbestosis, but let us today focus on what is the pathogenesis of pneumoconiosis itself. Hota kya hai isme? The lung reaction to mineral dust basically depends on a lot of different variables, including कि जो dust particles बंदे की body में enter हो रहे हैं उसका size क्या है, उसकी shape क्या है, वो कितना soluble है और उसकी reactivity क्या है with the host lung tissues. For example, particles which are greater than 5 to 10 micrometer, they are unlikely to reach the distal airways. सुने ना कि कितनी important बात है. आपका जो airway design है वो there is larger airways and then at the end of the day there are very small alveoli. So if there are bigger particles, ये इतना आगे तक जाएंगे ही नहीं, ये ऊपर ही कहीं फंस जाएंगे. So they will not be reaching to the distal airways. However, if there are particles which are less than 0.5 micrometer, they move in and out of the alveoli. यानी वो हर सांस के साथ alveoli तक पहुंचते हैं, since because they are very very small, right? Particles that are 1 to 5, which are moderate size, not very big, not very small, they are the most dangerous because they get lost at the bifurcation of the distal airways. Yani jahan ye bronchioles divide ho rahe hain, inki bifurcation pe they are lost like this. So they are literally causing this obstruction. Coal dust is relatively inert. Large amount must be deposited in the lung before the disease is clinically detectable. Yani inert ka matlab ye hai ki ye aisa particle nahi hai ki jo thoda sa body mein gaya and it will start causing symptoms. No, not like this. It will be required in big amounts if it has to do any clinical symptom. Okay, silica, asbestos and beryllium, they are more reactive as compared to the coila. Okay, and these particles, again, silica, asbestos, beryllium, they lead to fibrotic reactions even at very very low concentration. So ye different sare aapko batane chahiye ki coila bahut kam amount mein bahut zyada damage nahi karta, but the rest of them they are dangerous, right? However, some of the particles become impacted at the alveolar duct bifurcation where macrophages accumulate and engulf the trapped particles. So basically the foreign particles are coming in to the respiratory system, getting lodged somewhere, and there is an immune reaction against those particles and there is a fibrosing outcome. So jo lung tissue hai that will be fibrosed ultimately. Okay, the pulmonary alveolar macrophages is a key cellular element in the initiation and perpetuation of inflammation, lung injury and fibrosis. Yani pura jo pneumoconiosis ka cascade hai usme agar main aapse kahun ki what is one single immune cell which is super important, so that is macrophage. Following phagocytosis by macrophages, And you know, macrophages are professional phagocytes. So just like neutrophils, they can actually eat up the foreign particles. Okay, phagocytosis ke baad, many particles activate inflammasomes and they induce production of pro-inflammatory cytokines, interleukin-1 particularly, as well as some other factors which initiate inflammatory response, and that leads to fibroblast proliferation and collagen deposition. So it's a cascade of event. There is deposition of foreign particles such as coal or beryllium or asbestos, and because of this macrophages are activated, they engulf the particle, there is inflammatory events, interleukin-1 release, or phir jo lung parenchyma mein fibroblast hain, they are activated, and once the fibroblast are activated, they start producing fibrous tissue, collagen deposition and fibrosis. Okay, some of the inhaled particles may reach the lympharics either by direct drainage or within migrating macrophages and thereby initiate an immune response to the components of the particles or to the self proteins that are, so simple stuff. जब कभी कोई फॉरेन पार्टिकल होगा या वेन एवर देर इज अ डेब्री इन द टिश्यू, इट इज टेकन केयर ऑल्सो बाई द लिम्फेटिक सिस्टम. सो दीज डस्ट पार्टिकल्स और द डिफरेंट कॉम्पोनेंट्स, द चॉप्ड ऑफ यू नो प्रोटीन्स विच आर प्रेजेंटेड बाय द मैक्रोफेजेस इन कॉम्बिनेशन विद दीज डस्ट पार्टिकल्स, दे रीच टू द लिम्फेटिक सिस्टम. और एक दफा जब चीज लिम्फेटिक सिस्टम में पहुंच गई तो ज़ाहिर लिम्फ नोड में पहुंचेगी, और लिम्फ नोड में फिर बहुत सारे लिम्फ सेल्स मौजूद हैं, एंड दीज लिम्फेटिक सेल्स विल बी एक्टिवेटेड. So, एक bigger inflammatory response start हो जाएगा, ठीक? So, this leads to the amplification and extension of the local response. So, initially it seems like कि सिर्फ respiratory system में ये particles enter हो रहे हैं, but अगर ये lymphatic system तक पहुंच गए, then there is a widespread, broader inflammatory reaction. Tobacco smoking worsens the effect of all inhaled mineral dust because tobacco itself contains a lot of different inflammatory, initiators. So, इसमें बहुत सारे chemicals होते हैं जब आप cigarette पी रहे होते हैं. So, they can induce inflammation, and then there are these mineral dust particles. They can induce inflammation. So, altogether what happens कि if there is pneumoconiosis plus there is also smoking, that's a very bad news for the patient. Okay, so these are the general concepts. Ab phir hum karenge ye ki we'll talk about each one of them in a separate video. So coal workers pneumoconiosis for example will be the next, jisme we talk about the coal dust, phir silicosis ki baat karenge and asbestosis ki baat karenge. So you now have an idea ki what we are talking about. Pneumoconiosis is a restrictive lung disease. Kyun? Kyunki isme fibrosis hota hai. Har wo lung disease jisme fibrosis ho raha hai, that leads to restrictive lung disorder. Obstructive lung disorder is a different thing. It includes asthma, it includes COPD, matlab emphysema and chronic bronchitis, it includes bronchiectasis. So that's a different ball game. But restrictive lung disorders are because of fibrosis. Aksar student mujhe kehte hain ki sir hum ye bhul jate hain kyunki aap bar bar isme kehte hain ki when the coal dust particles come in, they get lodged here. So, jab wo lodge ho jayenge, so there will be obstruction. No guys, this is not the obstruction which is the hallmark of the disease here. Because of this obstruction, there is macrophage activation, macrophages engulf them, and inflammation is the hallmark of this disease. And so that the inflammatory mediators such as interleukin-1, it leads to activation of fibroblast and hence fibrosis. So fibrosis is the hallmark of pneumoconiosis and therefore it is a restrictive lung disorder. Okay, toh phir baat karunga coal worker pneumoconiosis ke baare mein in the next video. Till then, take care of yourself.